This is Fisher, Jensen, Chase. All right, this is mom and dad, Jonathan and Ashley. And so when you're praying for them today, pray that Fisher would know the love of God and share his love with others, all right? If you're praying for him today, that he would know God's love from a very early age and he would share that love with others. This is Ty Nathaniel Kim, rocking the hat. Hi, Ty. You okay? And then this is Henry and Bridget. And their prayer is that he would hear, that Ty would hear God's voice, that he would be courageous and use the gifts God's given him. This is Emma Marie Lozier.
We've done this before.
Yes.
Sorry, excuse me.
This is Big Brother Beckett. And this is Emma. And then this is Mark and Charisse. All right. Their prayer is that he would be, that Emma would be a strong and confident young woman. That she would be steadfast in her beliefs. All right. Baby numero four this morning is Whitney Abigail Miller, and this is James and Allison Miller, and I've been told that Whitney is a daddy's girl. We need to pray for James this morning, all right? He's already in trouble, and he knows it, all right? And as her namesake, Abigail, their prayer is that she would be generous, would live a life of integrity, honor, and generosity, that she would discern truth from error. All right, so that's the prayer this morning for her. This is Grace Brayton Murphy with Matt and Brooke. And they pray that Grace's life would be marked by empathy and kindness towards others, that she would find her identity in Christ. And last but certainly not least, this is Caitlin Elizabeth Reisner, Big Brother Justin. What's up, Justin? All right, buddy. This is Colin and Evelyn. And their prayer is that God would guide them as they model and teach this little boy and this little girl what it means to know the Lord. So this is Caitlin Elizabeth Reisner. Hi, Caitlin. How you doing?
Okay.
All right, so families, I have a couple questions to give you an opportunity to affirm your faith in the Lord this morning. Now, you, family, you realize this could get personal for you. Some of you, it's already personal. Some of you will be a part of helping these parents raise their kids by providing babysitting. Free of charge. Some of you may be led to do that. Others of you, a reasonable rate. Others of you will work with these little boys and girls, maybe already are working with them in the nursery, or you're going to be one of their primary teachers in elementary school here at Flood. All right, so it could get very personal. And again, so families, do you recognize this morning that your sons and daughters are a gift from God to you?
Yes.
Very good. And as their parents, depending on Jesus, do you promise to represent the Lord to your children by instructing them, by praying with and for them, and by providing them a foundation of grace and truth in which they can grow and thrive? All right, good deal. And is it your desire to seek personally to love God and to love others as an example to your kids? Very good. All right, family's gonna go ahead and dismiss you. Three of you can go down that way up here, and then four of you can go down this way up here. And if you know these, but as they're going, if you're here today as a family member, as a friend, to support these parents as they dedicate their children, would you go ahead and stand up so we can acknowledge you as they leave the platform? Yeah. Family, friends, it's already personal for you. Stand up. All right. And family, friends, and congregation members, I have a question for you. Is it your intention to come alongside these moms and dads to help them remove any barrier, any obstacle that would stand in the way of their sons and daughters coming to know Jesus Christ as their own personal Lord and Savior? Is that your desire?
Yes,
yes it is. All right. So if you know them, would you join them up here? Just put a hand on a shoulder. And you don't have to participate that way. You can pray where you're seated this morning. And I'm just going to lead us in a corporate prayer of blessing over these families. It is not easy being a parent. It's not easy being a kid in our culture. And so we want to go before the Lord on their behalf this morning. Father, we come before you and we recognize that every gift comes from your hand. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for these new members of our church family here this morning. Lord, we thank you for Fisher. We thank you for Ty. We thank you for Emma. We thank you for Whitney. We thank you for Grace. And we thank you for Caitlin. For the unique way in which you have made them in your image and likeness. We pray, Lord, that they would sense from their moms and dads the reality of your great love for them. We pray that they would be compelled by that love as they grow. That they would be men, they would become men and women who are marked by generosity, by integrity, by a conviction of understanding, Jesus, that you are the Lord, you are King, and that you gave your life for them. We pray that they would, that you would help these moms and dads to model faith, to model what it means to live a godly life, what it means to live a better story. And that they would invite their children into that story, a life of trusting you, of stepping out in faith. And God, we ask for your blessing as we dedicate these boys and girls to you today. We place them, these parents place their sons and their daughters in your hands. And Lord, ask for your protection, ask for your blessing, ask that you would give them wisdom, the moms and dads, wisdom and discernment to how best to parent, how best to teach and train their children the ways of the Lord. And so we pray that these children would flourish and that they would thrive. That Flood Community would be a place for them, Lord, where obstacles would be removed so that they could know you, the God who is, the God who was, and the God who will always be faithful. God, we thank you for your faithfulness. We commission these families into your hands, and we pray in Jesus' name this morning, and the church said together,
Amen. Amen. Amen.